Thank you, sir. Can we have the AV of Kumar Sumer Singh? Sumer Singh for his remarks and presentation of the awards.
Good afternoon, everyone. I really don't know whether I deserve to be taking up your time here at this conference. I did receive the invitation from Shamit, the Honorary Secretary, late last evening, so I suspect somebody dropped out. There was a speaker required, and he told me you speak for 2 minutes. Now, I don't know whether he really meant 2 minutes or whether because his wife, like me, is a teacher, and he thought if we get him on the stage, he's going to keep talking and keep talking like all teachers do. So I'll try and keep it as short as possible, but thanks a lot for having me here. Now, yesterday, or the first Kal, a typical example of what happens with the head of a school, because that's my experience, is education, schools, and colleges. So I'm going to give you an example from the head of a school. Everyone says the head plays a very important role in a school. And if you have a good head, you have a good school. The amazing thing is, a head is never trained. He's either a maths teacher, or an English teacher, or a geography teacher, or a physics teacher. And then one day, he's appointed the head of a school. And he's supposed to know, he or she, is supposed to know all about labor laws, finance, I didn't even know how to read a balance sheet, HRD, government laws, PR, I mean, suddenly you're supposed to know everything, but you are never trained for it. There is no course, there is no training to become a head, which is why they normally never appoint a head in the same school where he works, because then everyone would catch on that he knows nothing. So they pick him up and send him off far away to a school where no one knows him. And there, he tries to look wise and he tries to look contemplative so that his ignorance is hidden for some time. And it is that period, that initial period when he's a head, when he refers to the school in staff meetings and when he talks to parents and old students, he refers to the school as your school. Remember this, notice it the next time. He always talks about your school. He hasn't yet started identifying with it, but his ears are open, his eyes are open, and he is noticing things and hearing things. And this is his learning phase. When he gets a little more confident, he talks about our school. Now that is the productive time that has arrived. When he is still open to ideas, he is willing to discuss and exchange views and try and incorporate suggestions. Then comes the dangerous stage when he starts referring to the school as my school. That is the time either you get rid of him or you find a job and kick him upstairs, because your school is going to start stagnating and then go into decline. Every single suggestion that he receives, he perceives as personal criticism and does not want to hear it. He stops seeing what is there before him. And his subordinates recognize this, so they butter him up shamelessly because that's what he wants, and he swallows everything that they say. Now, this is the leadership trend of yesterday in a school. Today things have changed, and the change is that we are not looking for an individual leader. We are looking for a leading school or a leading organization. The role has changed of the head. He now has to build a team. He has to identify the right person for the right job. And having built a team, he has to then give responsibility, delegate, trust, and support. He has to pass on the credit for anything positive that happens. And he has to absorb the failures upon himself. Now he has a choice. He can also surround himself with pygmies and feel great about himself within the organization. But people outside the organization will not respect that organization. Or he can build leaders around him and build a leading organization which gets respect of people from outside, which brings satisfaction of work for those within. And therefore, that is the leadership requirement of today as a team leader. It is no longer necessary. As Mr. Bhargava said, a leader must continue to dream, he must continue to think. I say that is not necessary anymore. Within your team, there are so many people who are younger than you, who can dream, and they can come up with all kinds of ideas. Your job as the leader is not necessarily generating ideas. It is to be able to identify an idea which is a good idea, an idea which is a workable idea, to support that idea, and then to give credit to the person in the team who came up with the idea. You don't need to be a great thinker anymore, but you need to be able to recognize that in itself is leadership, to be able to pick up somebody's idea and then support it through and see it succeed. You pick up the wrong idea, it doesn't work. It brings discredit and it brings with it disheartenment. Tomorrow, before we go to tomorrow, let me just say that yesterday's leadership was I. Today's leadership is we. And tomorrow's leadership is the we plus social responsibility, because there is so much more awareness today that if you don't have social responsibility, you can't earn the respect. And therefore, tomorrow's leadership is the challenge of combining we with social responsibility. I hope I haven't wasted your time. Thank you very much.